What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be learning how to do the Sin City effect within Premiere Pro. If you want to learn how to do this, then stick around in the video and let's get started. Okay, so for those of you who don't know what the Sin City effect is, it's basically where you leave every single color apart from the red in your images, so the red sticks out and everything else is in black and white. So it's a very, very easy way to do this in Premiere Pro. This tutorial will not take long at all. First thing you want to do is obviously get your footage in of whatever it is that you want to leave the red. So in my instance, I've managed to find this clip online of the red helicopter flying away. It's quite good because the helicopter stays central, and I've also got a couple pictures to show you as well how it works on pictures as well as moving images. So once you've got your footage inside of Premiere Pro, come over to the left hand side and go to the effects tab next to your footage. Go to the search bar and type in leave. Once you have that, it should come up with color correction, leave color. So you want to do is click and drag leave color over onto your clip. It will then come up over here above where you've just got the effects tab. And down here you'll have leave color. It'll have amount to decolor, color to leave, tolerance, edge softness, and match colors. What you want to do is turn your amount to decolor up to 100. Then what you want to do is click the little eyedrop tool. Come over to wherever it is in your image that's going to be red. So in my situation is the red helicopter. Press anywhere on the red that you think is like a good shade of red. So for instance, I'm going to click there. And then what you want to do, if it does turn up like this, where it's like half red, half black and white, you want to go to match colors using RGB, go to using hue. And there we go. Red helicopter right there. Now, if you really wanted to, you could change the tolerance and edge softness, but if you do this too much, it's going to end up starting to sort of bring in the color of the grass and the greens, etc. So I think 15 is a good percentage for now. And edge softness as well. You could do it a little bit, but it does start to bring in the colors of the grass and everything else around it. If you bring it down too much, it can then leave the color away from your red object. And rather than a mask, this actually works on the actual video. So if I play the video for you right now, you can see that the red actually stays with the object that it's meant to be staying with, and it's not just a mask that is going to like go away. So this works perfectly for footage that you want like that. Now you do see there's a few people with like red jackets, or like I think there's a guy with an orange jacket. It does sometimes pick up other colors. So for instance, he's got an orange hat, and because orange is so close to red, it's going to stay there unless you wanted to like mask around the hat or something like that. But it's a lot of work that I want to do for something that's going to be so simple like this tutorial. We're now going to do the same thing for the images that I've got over here on the right hand side. So if we come over to this first image, we have some oranges on a plate with a little green sprite can in the background, white table. We're going to bring the leaf color over onto this image right here. We're going to change this to 100. We're going to do this and bring it over to like the middle of the orange example. And then a very quick effect right there. You see the table and the plate has gone a little bit darker, a little bit more black and white. Sprite can in the background for the most part has gone black and white, although there are a couple oranges there in the background. For this particular one, if you go to using hue, it will just pick up the color of everything, so it doesn't really look too much different. So in this situation, you do want to use RGB. If you're not quite sure which one to use, simply just switch between RGB and hue, and then you can see for yourself which one's easier to use. In my situation, it does depend on each picture, depending on what colors you have in the picture and which colors clash with others. So again, with this one, you can change the edge softness up if you wish to, although that very quickly brings in the color of everything else. And again, with the tolerance, if you do that any more than 15, it's going to bring up the color of everything else. And if you come down, it will start to eat away at the orange, and you'll see that the orange will turn black and white. That's why I think 15 is a good number for the most part. But if you can see very slightly around here, there are some black and white spots. There's one over there as well. So we're gonna change to 17, and let's change it a little bit better. So we're gonna go on to one more image, which is my final image, which is gonna be this image right here. It's one that, again, I took in New York, and it's just got some nice colors in it. I decided to use this picture. Even though the composition isn't the greatest in this picture, I thought with the colors, it would look really cool. So we're gonna bring leaf color over onto this clip. Again, we're going to change the decolor up to 100, press the little eyedrop tool, come over to the reds, use hue, and boom. Just like that, we have the reds from the Coke cans in the left-hand side. We have the red from the Coca-Cola labels here in the middle. I think that looks pretty cool. We're going to do one more color, which is going to be the green over on the Sprite cans. As you can see immediately, the Sprite cans on the right-hand side, all green. These labels are a little bit green over here, and all the lids down at the bottom also really green. So that's a very quick and simple tutorial, I hope anyway, on how to do the Sin City effect, how to leave color from everything else in the picture and in the video. And hopefully you guys learned something new. And if you did, please make sure to leave a like rating on the video and subscribe to the channel for more awesome tutorials of Photoshop, Premiere Pro, After Effects, Lightroom, and all that good stuff. And without further ado, thank you so much for watching this video. I'll catch you guys next time.